been locking myself away for 1 year to get the pocket symphonies done. And the special thing in composing this music was that I, for the first time, tried to do everything without an instrument. So normally you sit down at the piano or with the guitar, or I play some mallets, and I can develop a nice melody maybe, or a chord, find a chord. But I found out that the touch of the instrument on, or the physics of the instrument, they always make suggestions how to go. And if you miss a tone and play it wrong, then everything is gone, and it changes the direction so dramatically sometimes. So this time I just took long walks and tried to get the music done in my head, and then I wrote it down or I played it in the computer. So this is something in it that was special in the process. And the idea was to get like 12 songs that capture all evening moods, 12 ways of ending a day, but with my favorite instrument, which is the orchestra. So that's why it's symphony, and pocket means more, it's short, it's more a song than a whole tragedy or long story, a whole life. It's just episodes of a life. It's free, it's pure. It's the most songs have been totally have been complete, have been ready in my head before I started writing them down, which never happened when I composed by sitting on a piano. Then you have a chord and then you develop something around and you think of what could be next. Oh, this sounds great. And but walking and imagine the music is a totally different process, because it comes or it doesn't come. So that's why it took a year, because many days nothing happens, and then all of a sudden, under the shower or whenever you don't think even of making music, and all of a sudden there's an idea, a melody flying around, and then I try to develop this technique of going ahead like a story. And then when it's finished in my head and I can imagine the whole thing, then I put it down. There is also a problem with calling it classical, because it sounds so old, and it is not old. And also, it's for me, it's hard to define where does classical music stop and where starts the next thing. Where is that point? Is it in the 50s, in the 60s, or what is worth to get this name? And the same with contemporary music. What do you think about? What comes to your mind when I say contemporary? Then you think probably of something with strange chords and 12-tone music, something like that. And this is all difficult, because the pocket symphonies are contemporary music, because they are just composed. But using terms is always a tricky thing. I played drums in a hip-hop band very long in New York. And in hip-hop and in jazz, this is your idea. You make music for your homies. They come and we all live together, and there's not such a difference between the people in front of stage and on stage. Just on stage, it's a bit more concentrated, the whole thing. It's a reflection of the life of the people that live in front of the stage. So I hope that it's music for people that surround me, my friends, my family, and it's very mixed. It's workers and it's creative people, it's mixed people that travel, that are creative and interested in culture. And for those, it's not that I call somebody behind the mountain to take a listen to the pocket symphonies. It's just for you, for Christoph, for my friends, and I hope they enjoy it.